In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. We celebrate this weekend our first Sunday of Advent, our preparation for the wonderful Christmas season. Our theme, as always, will be repentance. As we listen to the readings, let's turn to the Lord first and be guided by His grace and ask for repentance from our sins.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, grant your faithful the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, we may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer, you are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you. While you wrought awesome deeds we cannot hope for, such as they had not heard of from old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All of our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you are the potter. We are all the work of your hands, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is, Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face and we shall be saved.
Lord, make us turn to you. Turn to your face, and we shall be saved.
O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse your power, and come to save us.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine, and protect what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man whom you yourself made strong.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
May your help be with the man of your right hand, with the Son of Man whom you yourself made strong. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you are called to the fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May Almighty God be in your mind, on your lips, in your heart, and may worthy and fitting proclaim his gospel. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight or at cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all. Watch." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Like I mentioned right at the beginning of Mass, we start our wonderful season of Advent today. And right off, we get hit with a reading from 3rd Isaiah, that third section of the book of Isaiah. We looked at that a couple of months ago, if you remember. And that was when we saw the first time in sacred scripture where we've got a writer who wants to take issue with something that's already been written in sacred scripture. In that particular time, it was about you may hate your enemies. We were actually taught, particularly the Moabites, and you can exclude from the worship assembly certain people who have deformities that make you uncomfortable. Third Isaiah said, that may be customary, that may even be written in the old Exodus law, but no longer. Now we get Third Isaiah again. We're right back in that section, and we get hit, and it was something very interesting this time. Listen to this. Just one verse from the reading that Court did for us. "Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways? Why do you let us harden our hearts so that we fear you not?" I'm going to bet most of us have heard this kind of thing said, maybe to ourselves. You can't teach that guy anything. You can't tell him anything. They have to go out and find out for themselves. What we hope when you have to say that about somebody is that they will survive waiting to learn on their own. Many times we look at what's going on in the world, all the things that are happening, and we may ask ourselves, Scripture does in the Psalms, where is God? Why doesn't he do something about all of these things? Maybe he tolerates a lot of what we do because the only way we can see how sinful we are is to let us go our own way. There's a companion reading to today's first reading. It comes out of the book of Ezekiel. Listen to this one. I love it, out of this 20th chapter. "Therefore, I gave them statutes that were not good." He allowed them to write statutes that were not good, "and ordinances through which they could not live. I let them become defiled by their gifts.
Wow.
So as to make them an object of horror. Sometimes the only way the Lord apparently can let us see what we're doing wrong is to just let us go as far as we seem to go. That's the first thing that they'll... Now the second one, it says... Again, let me read the verse again. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways to teach us? And why do you let us harden our hearts so that we hear you not? Now that one we need to think about for a second. Harden your hearts. Try to remember that the place that phrase is used most preeminently in Scripture is in the book of Exodus. And it's used toward Pharaoh. Can you remember that? The Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart so that all the plagues could take place. You remember? And even when he started seeing these things happen, his heart remained hardened. When the locusts attacked, and he goes to Moses and he says, you know, I've made a mistake. Ask your God to call off the locusts. And Moses prays to the Lord, and the locusts leave. And still, Pharaoh hardened his heart and wouldn't let the people go. That statement right there that Court read to us, that's a phenomenal statement. Because what has happened here is Isaiah is equating the Hebrew people with Pharaoh. Wow, what a statement. There are strong similarities many times between ourselves and that which we most strongly dislike or oppose. Isn't that fascinating? We say we hate violence, racism, and all these things that are raging in the world, but maybe we are so much like these things that we condemn, that we cannot see that we are really not condemning them. Now that's where 3rd Isaiah takes us. 3rd Isaiah is not any fun, is it? 3rd Isaiah really will come right at us with the things that are between us and the Lord that get between us. Not fun to listen to 3rd Isaiah, but at the beginning of Advent, a beautiful reading to tell us we really need to look carefully. What's the solution according to 3rd Isaiah? Repentance. He takes us right back to that. But if we are really to repent of our sins, I guess we first have to realize how much like our sins and the things we oppose we really are so that we can truly ask for forgiveness. This is where we start, and this is where we'll go for the next 4 weeks. We've got the opportunity to study that and let Isaiah and other readings take us to true repentance. If you join with me now, let's profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let's turn to the Lord now. inspired by our faith, and bring him our needs and special prayers.
For our church, that through our actions and words we may atone for our sinful ways, especially during this season of watchful expectancy for Christ's coming, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may hear the cries of those in need, the poor, the homeless, the persecuted, and the broken, and see the face of the Lord in their suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are burdened with guilt, that they may turn to God and come to realize the boundlessness of God's extravagant forgiveness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those around the world who suffer from HIV/AIDS, that they may know the tender, compassionate presence of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community who receive plenty to eat on Thanksgiving from our generosity, but struggle to feed their families and themselves every other day, that they may be remembered throughout the year, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, as we ready our hearts for your Son, grant that we may see your holy face in the faces of those in need, so that we might share from our blessings as you have shared your blessings with us. We make this prayer through the one whose coming we long for, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Let me receive. Please pray that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Lord, accept these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, through Jesus our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfill the design you formed long ago and open for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with all the angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy these gifts by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Anthony, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we too be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And now, at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with each of you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, and behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul will be healed. Let us pray. O Lord, may these mysteries in which we have participated profit us, for even now as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Go in peace. The Mass has ended.
Thanks be to God.